these are the points. We are in Austria. We've got a sprint weekend. So a total of 48 laps. This should be fun. Let's go. Hey, give me 100k, I could put deposit on the house, bro. But come on, mate. Jeff Bezos. Doesn't make a difference to you if you give me 100k. I'm just saying, Jeff. Like, you can just write it off as tax or something. I don't know. A tax write-off. So you get money off your taxes. It's a charitable donation. That's what it is. Come on, George, do something about it. Yeah, prick. He's not a prick anyway, but I just wanted to give one to George. George? I just said George instead of George. You had that kind of money just gifting it to random people. So you'd be like Mr. Beast. The Doncaster Mr. Beast. I don't know if you watch Mr. Beast, but like his content is based around giving things away. So he's giving people a private jet, a car, money. He'll do like a challenge, like if you win this challenge you get this much dollars. Nobody heard about it. Well, what I'm gonna say is he is, in terms of giving things away, he is something else. And he's still incredibly rich. A lot of people watch him, so makes sense. But like, he literally did like a YouTuber challenge recently. And the winner got a private jet. He did like, the last person to take your hand off this jet, it's yours. One of those challenges. That was for YouTubers, but he's done like things for like just regular people as well. The world is so too selfish, so kudos to him.
Okay, DRS will be enabled this.
Yeah.
You can use it when you're within 1 second.
He is quite the specimen, that's man. I don't think he's a billionaire though, but definitely a millionaire. He's got his own burger establishment. I think it's just called Mr. Beast Burgers. I think there might be one in England actually, might be one in London. Said kudos twice today. Well, maybe you're turning. I was gonna say turning American, but is that really an American term? Or is that just a general English term? See if I can keep Russell behind me as long as possible. Tend to have very good speed in the sprint, but clearly not fast enough for Lando. He's my direct rival. I wish Lando was a Ferrari behind me at this point. But he's not. Then again, I don't think, like, in the last sprint race, Imola didn't count. And I won that race, so...
Max is really pushing hard now. He's put in the fastest lap of the race.
Yeah, I can see that, mate. All you'd want is your own bar. I thought you said only your own car for a second. I'm just like, oh, you can get a new your own car, mate. What do you mean? Then I saw a bar, I'm just like, ah. You want your own bar, a few race horses, and Doncaster Rovers FC. You're asking for a lot there, bro. Like, I think the race horses might cost more than Doncaster. You know how much a horse costs? I don't even know about horses, and I know they cost a lot. I think you can just buy a horse that's not a racehorse, and it'll be expensive. If you could have anything. Well. You know, I had a dream. I had this weird dream, right? That I had a kid, right? And she wanted a horse for her birthday. And I remember being baffled, then I woke up. And I remember that I don't have any kids. That I know of. That's weird though. How can you dream that you had a kid? Hey, what's that about? See that? Hey look, I'm keeping Russell as far back as possible so Max Verstappen can catch up to him. You know, it's team tactics. I'm a team player. And then shagging bear women. Well, I don't know about bears, mate. I know you spelled it right. I just thought I'd make a joke. The opportunity was there, even though it wasn't really there. You didn't type anything wrong. So that's your takeaway, huh? I've been chatting with women. Not the fact that I had a dream that I had a kid, and that kid wanted a horse. So weird dreams, man. Yeah, dreams are very strange. It's always the best dreams that get cut short the most. I wonder if I could have done this on solves, then it would have been worth it. Probably wouldn't have been worth it. It would have gone so slow towards the end. Hey, look, listen, bro, it's just humour. It's just classic humour. Nothing more, nothing less. Being very petty here. Trying to keep him behind me as much as possible. Trying to remember a dream you had now. Well, we forget most of our dreams. Even on the day of the dream, we forget them. That's why, when you have a dream of any kind, when you wake up, write it down. I've never done this, but like, really you should. Because they're not easy to remember, really. may have hit the grass. I thought you just said you had a pee to absorb. I'm just like, what? How'd you absorb a pee? But actually, you said be right back. Yeah. Sick. This is not fair. But points, baby! Constructors points and max points. Want one of our drivers number one. If it can't be me, it has to be Max.
Okay, information on Djokovic. Okay, they're out of this race.
If I can finish third here, then I can also play villain again at the start of the next race and hold him back even more. And hopefully also overtake Norris and give Verstappen some protection. Who slowed down?
Caution, caution.
Just the one driver, well, two drivers actually. Schwarzman earlier. Didn't even notice who it was this time. So, what you missed, Jord, is you said, I need a PB right back. You didn't say anything wrong, but I read it as absorb. So I thought you were absorbing your pee, which would be weird because you're not a sponge. I don't know why a sponge would be used for pee. Jord's currently contemplating how to reply to that. Meanwhile, in like 2 months on YouTube, people might watch this thinking, what's he on about? This guy's weird. Yes, we take those. One day when you get big, is that a fat joke? I'm already big, mate. And you make these channel points relevant. How do I make them relevant? Like, well, how do I sort it out? I need to Google this. YouTube tutorials on how to set up Twitch properly.
Well, not the result our points leader would have wanted, but it certainly makes things interesting going forward. So let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings.
Max is
let's
just move on to the constructors. Just behind now.
Current leaders continue to extend
we
their
take
lead
those.
Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg and to a circuit
that's dangerous. That yeah, I know, right?
Has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship except the very first back in 1964.
It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet and his beard when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. It's one of the shortest laps on the calendar.
Never heard that intro before.
Seven rights and just three lefts, making up the 10 corners of this high-speed circuit. Turn two is barely a corner at all. They'll be flat out.
Yeah, they can test up and get banned, yeah.
Kink into the uphill braking zone of turn three. Turns one, three, and four are all potential opportunities to overtake. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. World champion Max Verstappen starts from pole position, and Lando Norris lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Davidson, Russell, Lance Stroll, and Gasly, Deruvala, Sainz, Oscar Piastri, and Daniel Tictum, Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, Alex Albon and Ocon, Richard Vershaw, Latifi, Kevin Magnussen and Guan Yu Zhou, Yuri Vips, Vettel, Drugovic and Robert Schwartzman. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. Now I wonder, Anthony Davidson, might we be in for some early pit stops today from the midfield teams? Trying to put a bit of pressure on or disrupt things for the leaders?
If you're in the middle of the pack, you know, you got your own race to run. I don't think they're going to be thinking about causing trouble up front. However, closer to the head of the pack, don't be surprised to see some split strategies. If you're running second and third, for example, bringing one car in for an undercut while leaving the other one out there longer can put a lot of pressure on the leader and maybe force them into an error.
Alright. I just do that. Oh, let's do that. Screw it, let's do it. Let's just do the default. Seems like a lot of people are doing the default anyway.
The formation lap is underway and the track temperature looks warm.
Signs on softs. Signs once again doing a two-stopper.
So as all the cars take their positions on the grid, the teams will be hoping their strategies pay off for them in today's race. The question I'm asking is which teams have got it right, which ones have got it horribly wrong?
I don't know about a fourth race today, guys. It's bloody... I say guys, it's just Jordi here. It's 2:41 a.m, bruv. When's this race going to finish? Like, 20 past 3, as I guess? You are two men. Is that what you identify as? So there's male, female, trans, and two-man jawed. Where did it go wrong for Max? What's going on? Go! Russell's been cocked. What's going on? Man's dropped below Sainz. Actually, Sainz is on softs to be fair, but he's got a pit earlier. Two men, one cup. Right. Definitely not going to be in DRS range of Max by the time it's lap 3. Never good at that turn. Even if I get it right, the exit's always too slow. Gonna get it, obviously. I wasn't even that far off, to be fair. But I will be. The fact that my rival's winning the race is a bit worrying. Make an unpredictable prediction, Jord, for the first F1 race of the season, Bahrain. Something that will happen that we don't think will happen. You caused this. That was funny. Charlie. This man is a prick, let me tell you. He wants revenge for that time I knocked him off the track at Monza. There's a Ferrari. Gaz is overtaking him now. For some reason my car couldn't turn because it was like right behind me. I'm just like, what's this?
Okay, you've got P3, well done. And that's Max ahead now.
P3's.
You've lost some time to the car behind.
Cheers, Jeff. Well, not Jeff, rather, I prefer Jeff. Bloody Russell. I'm getting rustled by Russell. Doing this for you, Max. You're first as well. I'm trying to keep him fourth, but I feel like in the pit stops he might overtake me. That's the only issue. See that.
They're in second. Okay, so the gap is 6.8 seconds. And the time last lap was at 1:08.4. There's a new strategy available on the MFD. Okay, copy that.
In reality, I'm going to pit when he pits. So whenever that is. That was a sneeze. Bless me. Flag? Who is it?
Okay, clear.
Is it a McLaren? It's a McLaren. Who is it? It's not Piastri, is it? It's Drubala.
Information on Drubala. Okay, it looks like the problem's terminal. They're retiring the car.
The safety car would be perfect because I would pit now and then everyone else has to pit, but that would require another car pitting. Sorry, another car's DNFing at me, slowing down. That's what triggers it, you need two cars to slow down. Damn, Norris ahead. That's annoying.
Yellow flag.
See where he was. I guess I'll go to him just looking back there. Thank you.
gap to the car in front is 9.7 seconds.
Almost worked. Just having a bit of fun, you know, just a bit of friendly banter. I was going to pit now, but because Max is in there, there's no point. Come on, let's be fast.
Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track.
There we go. Russell, that's the main thing. The fact that Sainz is just there is funny because he's pitting again. Best part of 15 laps remaining. I do wonder when exactly Sainz pits get on lap 8. We'll have gone 14 laps then. So soon, I guess. Should understand the strategy. Didn't work in Baku, I'll already try again. It's not like it's a phone anymore. You're nodding off! Damn! You fell asleep on my question, how dare you?
Okay, gap to the car ahead is 2.1 seconds.
I mean, we're not doing the four races tonight. Even I'm just like, well, it's past 3 AM now, it's just too late. But I might be on tomorrow. I want to finish 9 seasons before I go to America. And this is season 8. This is where science fits. What was it? I said name an unpredictable... make an unpredictable prediction for the first F1 race of the season in Bahrain. So something that people wouldn't expect to happen, but could happen. For example, last year, Haas getting a point, which they did. Ferrari getting a 1-2, Red Bulls both DNFing. That was a mad race last year. gave a lot of false hope for Ferrari fans, including myself. in before Aston Martin are actually fast. That'd be quite funny. I've got one. There will be an Alpine on the podium. You heard it here first. Alpine on the podium, bro. I don't know about that one. This is a bit outrageous, but, you know. Risks are there to be taken with predictions. Stroll's overtaken Russell. That's brilliant. Hopefully Max and Hodden are off, although they're still neck and neck. They have been the whole race. Seven laps to go. That reminds me, we've not done a save once yet in this race. Just gotta make sure. First, damn it, Max, damn it. Feeling there's something wrong with this car. I was like, why is he pushed back behind Stroll? And then, yeah. Gasly's now fifth. I think George nodded off thinking about the answer to that question. Seconds. Did I ask though?
The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 of that. Well done.
Okay, but did I ask?
Okay, gap ahead is 16.1 seconds.
I don't think Russell's even got a point now. He's even dropped below signs, just pitted twice. There's now a horse chasing him. Who's got fastest lap? It's not even on my screen. there's four laps left. You've already used up two, haven't we? We've got quite a few podiums in this, this particular season. Which is very nice. Hope you can secure this one. We've stayed 2 seconds ahead of Stroll for multiple laps now. So you should have enough speed to also keep this, like even if it's not 2 seconds, to keep up ahead of him. Maybe even stay out of DRS range to the end. As I say that, I lose a few tenths. Three laps to go.
Our gap to the car in front is 14.4 seconds.
Yeah, still 2 seconds ahead. Yes, to gain a second lap for now, from now, so we're good there. I think there's only 4 cars behind Russell, 5 cars.
Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
Funny. Completely no script there. Verstappen. Yeah, Norris is one. We've only gained, like, because Norris got first, we've only gained 8 points. 18 and 15, we've only gained 8 points. On Ferrari as a whole. Norris is the big win, though, because obviously he was spawning behind all three of us. Now gain some more, especially on his teammate. It's a podium. Oh, my left leg is done. Yeah, we're not doing four races. It's 3:24 a.m. I'm good. The sprint raced on me and that. But this is big for fantastic Russell in the worst way. Here in the Styrian Alps.
Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win? I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions, and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today, and the results speak for themselves.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari. So then, it's time to see how
right,
this
I am knackered, but there you go. Norris, the overall winner. In terms of the race,
who do you pick? Carlos Sainz would be my first.
Norris did get, oh yeah, got it at the end, didn't he?
Stamina, giving him the opportunity to charge through the ranks.
So it's really gained 7 points on Ferrari as well. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. But yeah, as for the standings, I'm just a mascot 16 point lead. I'm a further 16 points behind Norris. So behind Russell, sorry. So despite him not getting any points, I still haven't gained that. That shows how far I was behind, to be fair. Then you got Norris 20 points behind me. Interesting indeed. Interesting indeed. But I think he gains on a rivalry, unfortunately. That's the annoying bit. But in the Constructors, 36 points. It's not quite a race in hand, but yeah, we'll keep it. We'll take it for now. But ideally, we should at least be getting second anyway. But beating Ferrari would be too sweet. Even though I'm a Ferrari fan in real life. Yeah, that's an L there. It's annoying because, like, I was only 2 positions behind. I was just. At least we got our money. We'll definitely take that.
Let's take it slow. Where you go, I go too. And if you hit the bottom, I'm going down with you. Let's take it slow. Who cares where we gotta be? You know you'll have a good time wherever.